Well, good evening. It's the first time I've been able to say that because the earlier two services were in the afternoon. So thanks you for being a part of our third Christmas Eve service on this wet Christmas Eve. Just wanted to remind you of a few things. First of all, we do have a nursery available for children 0 to 3 years old. So if you need to access that during the service, that would be appreciated. Or if maybe they're a little bit older and they're having some trouble, there are some extra rooms there you can go and kind of settle them down if you'd like to do that. That would be great. Also, want to just let you know, if you're a guest with us, and maybe it's your first time here, we'd love for you to take one of our welcome bags on your way out. It's on a table in the foyer. Just take that home with you. Look at the stuff that's in there, information about our church. You can also fill out a card and send it back in the mail so we get to know you a little bit better. We'd appreciate that. I do want to introduce myself. I'm Pastor Jay, and I'd love to meet you after the service as well if you are a guest. Two more things. If you have a battery-operated candle, good for you. My suggestion would be that you leave it off during the service so that it works at the end when you want it. Because I can't guarantee the length of the battery, so if you could do that, that would be wonderful. And also, you are a part of an exciting kind of thing that's happening here at our church. We've never had a service go Facebook Live. You are Facebook Live tonight. Ooh. So on the count of three, I think, where'd he go? Oh, he's back there. Like Damon left. That's a bummer, man. We were on Facebook Live. So welcome to the Facebook Live people. On the count of three, let's wish them a Merry Christmas. 1, 2, 3. Merry Christmas. I'm sure that just made their night. Let's stand together. Let's sing some Christmas carols.
Hark the herald angels sing. Mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn. Christ the everlasting Lord, made in time, behold him come, offspring of the virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity, pleased as man with men to dwell, Jesus our newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die. Sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So sings of his hand. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in.
You may be seated.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appears and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn.
Evermore.
In those days, when Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, this was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna to our God.
You may be seated.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Join us again standing, please, as we continue to offer our Christmas carols and our service together.
Oh, come, oh, come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou dayspring, come and cheer our spirits by thy advent here. Disperse the gloomy cloud of night, death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou wisdom from on high, and order all things far and nigh. To us the path of knowledge show, and cause us in her way to go. Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Incense, gold, and myrrh, come peasant king to own him, the King of Kings, salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary.
You may be seated. Breaking through the silence with glory in the highest, the hope of all creation resting in his mother's arms. The song on the horizon ringing through the heavens, the long-awaited Savior come to set the captives free. Come to set the captives free. Come set us free. Hope has a name, Emmanuel, the light of the world, who broke through the darkness. The glory of heaven. We didn't see it coming. The story of redemption, which started in a manger, ended in an empty grave. Oh, I know that hope has a name. Broke through the darkness. All hail the King, Emmanuel, the light of the world, the glory of heaven. Come if you're broken, come if you're searching, if you need healing, he's where you'll find it. Lay down your burdens and breathe in forgiveness. If you need freedom,
Yeah, he's where you find it. Oh, if you need freedom, he's where you'll find it. He's where you'll find it. Oh, hope has a name, Emmanuel, the light of the world, who broke through the darkness.
Well, it is my privilege to again share with you on Christmas Eve. I had this opportunity many times, and I always look forward to it. It seems like each year brings with it its own catchphrases or buzzwords. Each year kind of has certain things. And I would say that 2020 was no different. As a matter of fact, there was some pronounced catchphrases that emerged during 2020. Things like, we're in this together, or lockdown. Outdoor dining was used a lot more in 2020. I'm just working from home. That's another one. Isolation, quarantine, and the list could go on and on and on about certain words or phrases that became just really used a lot in 2020. But as I was thinking about sharing with you tonight, I thought about one word that I really think was used a lot as well in 2020, and the word is hope. And hope was used in connection with a number of different things. People were hoping for physical health. People were hoping for mental health. People were hoping for the economy to improve. People were hoping for education, schools, and everything related to that, and colleges. People were hoping for relationships or connections to kind of improve or even to start again. We hoped for things like reconciliation. And as a lifelong athlete and also a coach, I was kind of hoping for sports. So we had lots of things that we were hoping for, and I would say that hope was consistently on our hearts and minds this past year. Author Paul Tripp says this about hope. He says, every human being is hardwired for and concerned about hope. We are all in a constant search for hope that will deliver and that will last. He goes on to say, we're all a bit discouraged and paralyzed when our hopes are dashed. And when one hope dies, we tend to grab hold of another hope as fast as we can. So I get it. So it's kind of for us to be thinking about hope. And I would suggest to you that hope is a very powerful word. It really is. But it has limitations. Hope has limitations depending on how you define it and where it comes from. And so we can think of hope in a couple different ways. One way that people talk about hope is wishful thinking. I hope my finances get better. I hope my family stays healthy. I hope I can see more people. And for me, I hope it's a mild winter. So we have these things that we're wishing for, we're hoping for. And when we think about this definition of hope, it's almost like this. If I desire something hard enough, if I want it bad enough, maybe it'll happen. And that's kind of how people maybe approach hope these days. And that's okay because I know they're trying to have it not just for themselves, for other people. But there's a problem with that definition of hope. That definition of hope has severe constraints that come with it. And here's why. As much as we may want things or desire things, they don't always happen, do they? They don't always happen the way we want them to as much as we may hope about that. And frankly, this kind of hope is not the hope that we celebrate at Christmas. It's not this kind of, well, just if I can just kind of desire it enough. It's not the hope at Christmas. So the question is, what is Christmas hope? I want to give you a definition. I want you to look at it behind me. Here it is. Christmas hope is confidently looking forward to what is good and beneficial. That sounds good, doesn't it? Looking forward to what is good and beneficial, but it's based on trusting in the right person. That's how you and I are going to make our way to Christmas hope. Confidently looking forward to what is good and beneficial, based on trusting in the right person. So where do we find this kind of hope? Well, some people try to find it in improved circumstances. I just want my circumstances change, or my health gets better, or my finances improve, or my relationships get better. Some would say that really Christmas hope is about having more good days than bad days. Or that Christmas hope is just the fact that I'm just going to be tough enough to make it through. Some of you just say, yeah, I'm going to be tough enough. But all those things fall really short. They're really not what Christmas hope is all about. Because as we alluded to in this definition, we find Christmas hope in a person because Christmas hope has a name. And the name is Jesus. That's where our hope is found. It's not found in these circumstances or things getting better or getting worse or us just trying to desire or just will things into us. Our hope has a name, and it's Jesus Christ. That's why we celebrate. That's why we can celebrate the end of 2020 and celebrate going into 2021. In the Gospel of Matthew, Matthew quotes the prophet Isaiah. The words of Isaiah that he quotes were given several hundred years before Jesus was here on earth. But Matthew quotes this prophecy as Jesus is in the middle of his ministry to let people know what Jesus is up to. And it's just a small part of the prophecy, but it's very powerful. Here's what it says in Matthew 12:21. In his name, the name of Jesus, the nations will put their hope. Now, at first glance, you're like, yeah, okay, that's a nice verse. Maybe you're missing something here. This is so powerful because when Isaiah and then when Matthew includes the nations receiving hope, guess who that includes? All of us, because this means that Jesus has expanded. When he came at Christmas, he came to give his life to expand the hope beyond Israel to Gentiles like you and me. And because of that, you and I have the opportunity to find that Christmas hope in the name of Jesus Christ. He is the only person who can bring the kind of hope that we need. He's the only person. It's the only name. So hope does have a name, and Jesus is the name of that hope. J.I. Packard puts it this way. The Christmas message is that there is hope for a ruined humanity. Hope of pardon. Hope of peace with God. Hope of glory. Because at the Father's will, Jesus became poor and was born in a stable so that 30 years later, he might hang on a cross. That name becomes the Christmas hope for us, but he must be born to do it. And I would say to you that Christmas hope found in Jesus Christ is the best hope going. It's the best hope going. And if you don't believe me, I'm going to give you a couple reasons. I'm sure you're asking for them. Here they are. The Christmas hope of Jesus is the best hope going for several reasons. Number one, Jesus Christ meets our greatest need. You know our greatest need is more money in the bank? Our greatest need is not to always be healthy or always have days or always have the car start. That's not our greatest need. Oh, those, even though those things are kind of nice. Our greatest need is to be forgiven of our sins. And the hope of Christmas, Jesus Christ, is the one who does that. All these other things can't touch it. I love the words of the angel to Joseph. He says, you shall call him Jesus. Why? Because he'll save his people from their sins. So he meets our greatest need. The best hope going. He also takes us through the hard times. The hope of Christmas takes us through the hard times. The Bible says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him. I don't know about you, but it seems like in 2020 there's been a shortage of joy and peace. Huh? Maybe not you, just other people. But do you realize that through the hope of Jesus Christ, the Christmas hope, that external circumstances do not have to destroy your joy and peace because you have hope in him? and it can take us through anything that comes our way. Because I have no idea what you will face in the next year. I have no idea, and don't ask me, because I am not that kind of a prophet. Nor do I want to be, based on the Bible's strict criteria for one strike and you're out. But I can tell you this, if you have a relationship with Jesus Christ, the hope of Christmas, whatever you face, the God of hope will give you joy and peace. He promises that, not just at Christmas time. When the carols die down and the decorations finally leave the stores and all this kind of stuff and your tree makes it to the road, he's still there as the one who will go through everything with you. The hope of Christmas. He also is the best thing going because he connects us to God right now. This is not a pie in the sky or a later on event. The hope of Christmas allows us to be connected to God right now. One of my favorite names of Jesus given at his birth is Emmanuel, which means God with us. So it wasn't just Jesus saying, yeah, I'm here, and maybe later on you'll be able to experience a relationship with God. It'll just be way, way, way in the future. No, now God is with you, and if you experience the hope of Christmas, you can connect to God right now. And that's hopeful. Another thing that makes the hope of Jesus just the best hope going is because it guarantees our future. It does connect us to God now, but it guarantees our future. I mean, you know how many people are worrying about their future these days? Just about so many different things. And we're not saying we don't have concerns or we don't plan things. I'm just saying I know that because of the hope of Christmas, my future is guaranteed. Listen to the words of the Apostle Paul. He says, if only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are all people most to be pitied. That means if Jesus Christ, the hope of Christmas, is only good for this life and not the next one, we should feel sorry for ourselves. But that's not the case. The hope of Christmas not only connects us to God now, but he ensures our future with God. And that should be an encouragement to us. R.C. Sproul said, hope is called the anchor of the soul because it gives stability to the Christian life. But hope is not simply a wish. I wish that such and such would take place. Rather, hope is that which latches on to the certainty of the promises of the future that God has made. There's one final thing that makes the hope of Christmas the best hope ever. It's 3-in-1. It's bonus material. The hope is for certain. No doubts here. It's for certain. It endures anything. And it's not subject to external circumstances. Wow. It is certain. It is enduring. And nothing that happens outside will change it. That's the best hope ever. Wow. As a matter of fact, I offer this up to you. Go ahead, Charlie, and go to the next slide. This little acrostic to represent what Jesus did. Jesus is the Christmas hope. What does he do? He offers peace everlasting. Not temporarily, not just on the good days, not even just on the bad days. All the days he offers peace everlasting. That's the Christmas hope we share. So because of this Christmas hope and what Jesus has done for us, I'm pretty excited about this. It encourages me, but it also leads me to kind of the final question I want to share with you. And here it is. How do I find that Christmas hope? I mean, if it sounds so good, it really is, how do you find it? Well, some try to find it by just doing the best they can. You know, I'm just going to do the best I can, and he'll take care. No, it's not going to work that way. Or some think it's arrogant for anybody to suggest that you could find that kind of hope. I don't think it's arrogant for this reason. The hope of Christmas through Jesus Christ is not arrogant to me because it reminds me I can't do this. I can't do this on my own. I need help. Opposite of arrogance. I need Jesus Christ. So how do we find this hope? Well, the hope comes by placing your faith and trust in Jesus Christ, what he has done for you, dying for your sins, rising again, trusting in him as your Christmas hope. In just a moment, I'm going to pray. And during this prayer, I'm going to invite you, if you've never done that, to give your life to Christ. To kind of pray the prayer with me. And there's nothing magical about the prayer. It's just a prayer of commitment. So I want you to join with me as we pray. God, thank you for the encouragement you have given to us through the hope of Christmas, Jesus Christ. Thank you that hope has a name. It's not intangible, it's not nebulous, it's not just fuzzy. It is concrete and certain through Jesus Christ, and we celebrate that. God, I also pray for anyone here who has never placed their faith and trust in that name of Jesus, in that hope of Christmas. And right now, as we pray this prayer, God, I would encourage those who have never done that to pray this prayer from their heart to your ears the most sincere way they can. And if you haven't done that, I would encourage you to pray this prayer with me, just silently to God, making this commitment. Dear God, I know that I need the Christmas hope of Jesus. I need my sins forgiven, and I believe that Jesus came and he died for my sins and that he rose again. And God, as best as I know how, I give my life to Jesus right now. And God, as I do that, I thank you for the gift of Christmas hope that not only starts tonight, but will stay with me my entire life and even into eternity. So I make that decision to you tonight in Christ's name. Amen. I would encourage you that if you have prayed that prayer, made that commitment, please see me afterwards or someone that you came with and just let them know that you've made that decision, because we would love to follow up with you and get you some resources and help you on this journey. Matthew West recorded a new Christmas song called The Hope of Christmas. And part of the song goes like this: "Take me back to silent night. My heart was full and the world was right. 'Cause right now the world looks nothing like those innocent Decembers. These days, peace on earth is hard to find, and I need you to remind me one more time that you're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas, and you're still the hope of my heart." And he was talking about Jesus. And I want you to know there is still hope at Christmas, a lasting and certain hope. And this hope has a name, folks. Jesus. We're going to pray, and the men are going to come to help me as we pray and move into our candle lighting. God, again, thank you for the celebration of who you are and who you have sent us through Jesus Christ. God, again, pray if there is someone who has given their life to Christ tonight, that they would really just seek out somebody and take the opportunity to share that decision so that we can help them. God, we rejoice, and as we move into just finishing with worship, we pray that it be pleasing to you. And we ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. These men are going to light candles on the end of the row, and then you're just going to pass them along to somebody in your row. As your candles are being lit, just to remind you that if you have a battery-operated candle, now is your time to turn it on. And also, as we sing, I would encourage you to sing to the left or the right of the candle flame. That's most beneficial for you to do that. Please join us standing. Peace. We're going to end our service by singing a song of blessing over each other as we finish our time together. To you, Lord, turn his face toward you and give you peace. Lord, bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Christmas to you, Facebook Live people. Merry Christmas. As you blow out your candles, please do that carefully. You can distribute them back in the baskets on your way out. Again, Merry Christmas. Thank you so much for coming. You are dismissed.